my usual day. We get up about sort of 6:30, 7 o'clock. Make sure we check all the animals first, make sure none of them got tangled or hurt themselves during the night. Then we feed the horses, let them out of the stables, put them out to graze, muck them out, which is a lovely job. Give them a good muck out. Then we let the chickens out, feed the chickens, feed the geese, collect the eggs that the chickens have laid, hopefully, and then go and feed the sheep. And basically potter about with the animals, bring the horses in, groom them, make sure everything's okay. Come back about sort of 4 o'clock and repeat the whole process, but bring the horses in, feed them, give them a good groom, lock the chickens up to prevent the fox from getting them, and feed the geese and put them to bed and give the sheep a little titbit so they don't feel left out. And then off home we go.
Farms like this one are quite common in Britain. In the UK, there are approximately 300,000 active farms with an average size of around 57 hectares, much larger than the European average size of approximately 20 hectares. Britain has a total farming population of around over 500,000 people, which is less than 1% of the population. But agriculture uses around 3/4 of its land area, and it's also a key element in the economy, contributing £5.8 billion in 2007. The British countryside is a quiet and relaxing place. It's less mountainous than Italy, so there are more open green spaces, especially in central England. Go in late spring or early summer if you want to see it at its best. Most villages have changed little over the years. Nearly all have a characteristic pub as their focal point, although unfortunately some of these have closed in the last few years. And some phone boxes survive despite mobile phones. In most countryside areas, houses cost on average £8,000 more than in urban areas. And the result is an ageing population as younger people move out of the countryside for education, work opportunities and affordable housing, while older people move into rural areas when they reach retirement age. 2/5 of countryside residents are aged over 50 years old, and 1/4 is over 60.